Hey, welcome back. It's Annalie and Annie, and you are listening to the Let's Go There podcast, where we are going there on all the hard Christian topics that you have been dying to hear about. Yeah. We are already on episode 11.
That's crazy.
Which is amazing.
Amazing.
And we are hitting it hard. We are talking about the mark of the beast, which I know you guys have been dying to hear about. Yeah. So we're very excited about
right.
this one.
Let's just dive in again to, you know, conversations that, you know, are explosive.
Well, and for sure, like, again, we're not the experts on this, but we are providing the conversations and asking those questions that you would like to ask, but probably don't have that person to conversate with.
Right.
So that's
exactly.
what we're doing.
Yeah. We just want to kind of, we like to lob it out there and then let you guys go do a deep dive on your own and even provide resources of different places that we've, you know, dipped into. This is definitely, I think, on the forefront of any believer's mind. And if it's not, do you have a pulse? Like, because, it definitely should be.
Oh, yeah.
You know, for sure. Mm-hmm. We need to be aware of what's going on. And the enemy would love, for us to be completely unaware of the times that we're living in. So we just start, if you are listening to us for the first time, we believe that we are living in the last days and that we're going to see the return of Jesus Christ in his kingdom. But before all that takes place, we do believe that we are going to go through the tribulation period. Yeah. We have other, podcasts that go into the rapture. We do believe in a rapture, a biblical rapture. But you can go into those two podcasts to look at the timing of that. So, but for this one, the mark of the beast is something that we feel is it's relevant. It is it's our immediate future. It's very soon.
Yes. Yeah. And churches aren't talking about it.
Not at all.
Yeah.
Completely sleeping and unaware.
Yeah. Unaware of
exactly.
the times.
So. Yeah. Okay. So let's just start off with the New World Order. Okay. Because you can't have the mark of the beast without the New World Order. It's the whole, we call it in the Bible, the beast system. And really what the Lord is calling the church to do right now is to come out of that beast system, the Babylonian system. You're already starting to see that be implemented. But that New World Order is building a global cloud network to monitor every human being, listen to this, through the internet of bodies, including controlling every transaction. I mean, we already know that. We're seeing that right now, right?
Yes, that's obvious right now, I would think.
Yes, right. I mean, down to like, okay, I didn't know that I had current events, but I do. Mm-hmm. There are these ear pods that are new that will actually be able to monitor your brain waves and actually know which part of your brain is being used, which then will interpret what you are thinking about and then actually go back and the data would be collected. So these are the kinds of things like down to your thoughts, like
even
or your Apple Watch.
You say that. Yes. So there's an Apple VR.
Oh, OK.
That is tracking your eye movements, that will track your eye movements and know what you're into, if you are,
what you're focusing on, the point, it's getting to the place where it's actually going to potentially be reading your thoughts, to speak.
Oh, for sure.
So
they're going to know everything about
every movement that you're making. When you watch this, broadcast from the government, what your heart rate is doing to let them know, are you against it?
Yes.
Are you rebellious according to their,
it's
plans? All sorts of things all synthesized. So this is the plan. And those without, though, the whole idea is the mark of the beast will not be able to buy or sell just as predicted in the Bible.
Yeah.
And this is not some scientific, sci-fi, I'm trying to say, kind of movie out there scenario. It's like, this is happening.
Oh, for sure.
And I feel like it's that picture of like the frog in the kettle and it's just getting warmer and warmer and we don't realize it until it's too late.
Oh,
we're in
sure.
this boiling pot.
Yeah. Well, in America specifically, because if you're in China already, they already have that database. They track every movement.
Yeah.
You're on a score, like how well you're doing in the system.
Right.
And so it's already happening in other places.
It's
just slowly trickling in here and to the people that aren't aware.
And
it's
I would say faster than, people are.
Well, that too. I feel like it's
accelerating right now.
For
and I feel it's like on every single level.
Yeah.
for this to be all set in place so that every single human being on the face of the planet would have to take this specific mark that we're talking about.
Did you see, like, there's supermarkets now here that are actually, you have to walk through this where there's sensors.
Yes.
And they're starting to close off the entrances.
Yes.
And you have to go specifically through these doors.
Yes. I mean, and even cashless, like cashless mm-hmm. airports. The coffee shop we were just in, the sign, cashless, you know, because they can't actually know where you're spending your money when it's cashless. So it's to monitor every, but even biometrics, like what your body, like we were talking about, what your body is doing. And so this is taking place all around us right now. I know. Yeah.
Crazy.
Yes. So the planners of the New World Order are already creating crisis. You know, they're going to keep amping that up in order to collapse nation states in the present world order. So the way that we operate now, it's going to continue to bring crisis upon crisis because it can't have autonomy within nation states. We're going towards this new world order, which then will implement this mark of the beast that will track every single person and literally make it that you can't buy or sell, like if you do not have this mark.
Yeah, and we saw the first stages of that with the COVID vaccine where you couldn't leave. You had to show, is it called a COVID passport?
There's a COVID passport, and then there was also, if you didn't have that, you had to show signs that you had recently taken a test and you're positive or negative. And obviously, if you know you had it, you couldn't fly.
You couldn't leave.
You couldn't travel.
No.
You couldn't go actually up in LA. There was places like you couldn't go into restaurants.
Yeah.
You couldn't go into gyms. I mean, we've already seen this take place, and that was like, you know, a tester to see how compliant the sheep will be.
For sure. Yeah. So if you're like, no, this is crazy out there, I'm like, no, this happened.
Well,
it's
we just went through a massive world. I mean, well, yeah. I'm like, how do we stay on point with this one? Because I'm like, oh my goodness. I mean, we're already getting tested and all these things where all flights were canceled by the FAA for an entire day. And that has not taken place since the day after 9/11.
I know.
And then I believe it was Canada was also all their flights grounded. And then there was another, like, I think it was like a month ago that this took place in Asia also.
Yeah.
So there's testings happening. There's things that are like right now how far this thing is going to go, and the Bible tells us how far this thing is going to go. The Bible predicts that this satanic vision will be realized. It will actually take place and be established for 42 months towards the end of this decade before the rapture of the church to meet the Lord in the air. So this is not something that is going away. This is actually happening. It's taking place. And I think the more that we can live in the truth and the reality of the times that we live in, you can be prepared, because this is so fascinating. The world is preparing for war and things that are to come. You know, Russia's amping up the United Nations with, you know, Ukraine, and we can go into all that maybe in a different podcast, but they're preparing for war right now. And the church is preparing for nothing.
Nothing.
I mean, like, and the Lord goes, I tell you all these things so that you actually wouldn't be caught unaware.
Yes. That's why it's all in the Bible. Every step that's going to take place, it's just that we haven't looked there and we haven't been taught.
Exactly.
Yeah, which is sad.
It's not being said. Maybe, I don't know, I guess, so that we would be unprepared. It is a tactic of the enemy.
For sure.
The prime objective, though, of the one world government, one world economy, one world religion, is to persecute the saints for rejecting worshiping the Antichrist as God. So, you know, he causes all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead, that no man might buy or sell save he that had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him that has understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of man, and his number is 666, which is the number of man. Revelation 13, verses 16 through 18.
For sure. And so I looked up that word worship.
Oh, yeah.
Because I think a lot of churches now, it's like you're going to be singing to this God, worship, like, like the worship we understand as in church.
Right.
But the actual meaning of that word is submission.
Mm. I've even heard to bow the knee.
Yeah,
to it's literally bow prostrate. Like it's a posture. Mm-hmm. Yes, exactly. Because mm-hmm. that's the first time with Abraham, it's to bow.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. So even that alone is just understanding what that means.
Well,
it's
and
completely
people,
different.
It's like I've heard Christians say, you know, Annie, it's going to be this very determined thing of, you know, one line to Jesus and one line to Antichrist and who is God, and it will be obvious and it will be known.
Yeah.
And, you know, I always bring up like, but, you know, let's talk about who we are dealing with. Mm-hmm. Satan is literally the father of lies.
Yes.
He brings confusion wherever he goes.
Yeah.
It's to bring, to rob, to steal, to kill, to destroy. And so when you look at even Adam and Eve and the deception of the fall, it wasn't like, here, eat this forbidden, you know, fruit.
It's going to kill you.
And it will kill you.
No.
There was a deception. You're going to be like God.
It's good for you.
Right.
This is good for you.
It will protect you. It will be helpful to you.
Yeah.
It will. And when you are faced with, and this is where it's like people need to decide now, knowing mm-hmm. that these things are going to come and they're very soon on the face of the earth. Where will you stand?
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's one thing to be able to say, well, I mean, it's obvious, but you need to think of like what the reality of that is. I can't buy food. I can't sell, make money to buy food. And mm-hmm. you have children and you have, you need to play this out and you decide now. You don't prepare for the storm and build for the storm in the middle of the storm. You build your house on the rock and the word of God and who
prepare
you
now.
Align yourself with. Exactly. You decide now.
Yeah. And I think that's another deception is you will hear pastors say you won't be deceived into taking this. Revelations 13:14, mm-hmm. it's a couple of verses before it talks about taking the mark of the beast.
Okay.
It says he deceives the whole earth and all those who dwell in it.
Wow.
That's everyone.
Well, and even says, okay, that the Antichrist won't be revealed until the great falling away.
Yeah.
Well,
so
the
there
falling
is a deception.
Away of who? The falling away of the saints.
Yes, for sure. Even Eve was like, she told God, the serpent deceived me.
Exactly.
So there is a deception. It's not going to be like, this is the mark. Do you want to take it
right.
or not take it?
Well, and here's the thing. It's not to put you into a spirit of fear. That's not what we are doing. That's not what God does. God actually brings you the truth because like we've been saying, that literally the sons of God are going to be made manifest in the book of Daniel in the last days.
Yeah.
We will be doing great exploits.
Yes.
But it is for the overcomers. We know that you guys are the remnant, and that's who we're talking to right now.
Yeah.
It's there is a place for the overcomers. So God actually, he's like, you have to actually know what you're up against and have your eyes be open.
There's more fear if you don't know what's happening.
Exactly.
I would think.
You can't prepare for what you don't know
and
is coming.
And just like the wise virgins, you prepare now, having enough oil, walking with the Holy Spirit.
Exactly.
So when the time comes, you're ready for it.
Yeah, right.
Mm-hmm.
So God will preserve his people.
Yeah.
You know, he's done it before. He's going to do it again. You know, so, you know, but we need to be aware of this beast system and know that it won't prevail over the saints.
Mm-hmm.
There are those that are going to be perfected in this time. You know, there are those that are going to give their lives for Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
It says, right, you know,
Daniel,
they overcame him by the
blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony.
And they loved not their lives even unto death.
Yes. Yeah. And
so
they overcome. Oh, yeah.
That's how they overcome.
Mm-hmm.
Now, but there's also those that God is preparing now, where you are literally on your knees, you are living in a place of not religion, and you break off any religion, you repent for any religion that you are connected to underneath. You say, God, show me. And you actually ask the Holy Spirit to reveal to you. And this is a time of maturing right now.
Oh,
I know I'm going through it myself. There
mm-hmm.
is a refining that's taking place on a level that is like amazing.
Because Jesus is coming for a pure and spotless church.
Exactly. And she kind of ugly right now.
Ooh,
so, you know, it's like we gotta.
We're being perfected.
We are being perfected.
Yeah.
We're being sanctified. We are becoming the bride that the bridegroom actually is worthy of. And that is amazing to be able to think about that you've been chosen and I've been chosen, Annalie, for such a time as this.
Yeah.
It's an honor and it's a privilege. It's something that he says, I've actually preordained that you would live in this time period. So that you would actually overcome.
Yes.
Yeah.
I love that. All right. So we've talked about in previous episodes about it as in the days of Noah.
Yes.
Like we're going to know that this is in time. Well, with timelines as well, but we can talk about that later. But as in the days of Noah, and what were they doing in Noah's time was they were changing the DNA, right?
Exactly.
And so we're asking the question, what could this mark be?
Right.
And although we don't know, and we cannot say specifically what it is, it's good to be aware of the things that are taking place now so that you are prepared mentally going forward.
I just saw, I think I sent you a video on how they now have reported, and this is what they're reporting to us, which means they've done a whole lot of other stuff that we don't know about, of making a synthetic cell that literally is viable. Like it goes into the body. It has different people's names written on it. Authors of it with code within a code within a code. And I mean, like this is the world that we're living in.
Well, I was doing a little bit of research on this. So our DNA so it's a double helix and it's tied together with the adenine, thymine, cytosine, guanine. This is the DNA code that connects us together. And there's a sulfuric bridge that after every 10 pairs of nucleotides, every 5 pair of nucleotides, every 6 pair of nucleotides, and every 5 pair. So 10, 5, 6, 5. And there's this code that is like over and over in the Hebrew alphabet. Every letter has a number.
A numerical value to it, right?
Yeah, and it spells out Yahweh. And so it's such a beautiful
in the DNA strand.
Yeah,
know we are. It's Psalm 139. I knit you together in your mother's womb before I pre. I mean, it's just
Genesis 1:27 says God created man in His own image. He's put His signature in every one of us. It's so beautiful.
So you have to go back. Then what does the enemy want to do? Yes. He wants to copy God. He says, "I am God. I want to be God." Therefore, he wants worship as God. That's what the Antichrist is going to do. That's what we're talking about. This is the connection here. And so he literally wants to say, I want to write my name on you.
Let's change that up.
Yeah.
So that just like the days of Noah. So when we talk about the vaccine, which again, could be a precursor. We don't know if this is the thing, but it adds in that code where the six is, it adds an extra two sixes. Wow. So it's 666. And so, again, we've been told in the scriptures what to watch out for, what to look for.
Right.
Now, when things point to a certain direction, it's just like, whoa, you got, okay, let me pray about this.
We need to not run to man for our solutions. This is a warning for you and for us right now. The word of God is telling us that it's time for us to not run. We are being called out. Yeah. We're being called to be separate.
Yes.
We're being called to not rely on, the government saving us.
Oh, goodness.
Even a vaccine to save us. I mean, we just did a podcast on Jehovah Rapha, that he's the God who heals.
Yeah.
And you know, we're not against modern medicine and all those kinds of things. But within this time period,
Very careful.
You need to understand that the mark is something that is on our horizon. And so you are going to look at things very differently than any other generation has before.
Yes, for sure.
Yeah.
You have to. And that's why God has given that to us.
Right.
So we're prepared for that.
Exactly. So it's definitely something that, okay, so what do I do with all this information? What do I do with knowing that the mark is here, the one world government is imminent? It's the answer is always simple with the Lord, but I think it's the most uncomfortable for people because it's actually having a revelatory relationship with Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
It is not that I go to Sunday school and they rotely tell me what to do and I check it off the box and I'm doing what everybody else is. I went to Bible study, I read the Bible, but what is the Bible actually saying to you to do with your family?
Yeah.
And it's going to be that thing where literally the Lord is speaking to us in dreams, in visions, literally telling us, it says, you know, your teacher no longer behind you will hide himself, but he will actually start to tell you, go to the right, go to the left. And these are the days right now where you need to have that kind of real relationship with your Savior who has filled you with His Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And you say, we're in times of prayer, we're in times of fasting right now, and we're crying out to God. And it's not going to be based on any man's voice.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be based on the voice
only
of God
and
then connected to the Word of God and what the Word is actually saying. And so that's the voice that we need to be listening to, tuning our ears. Yeah. This is your preparatory time right now, because these are the days that we're walking into.
Agree.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure. The beauty is God doesn't want us in darkness, that day should overtake us. And we've got it all here.
Right.
So this is awesome. And then we can go in the timelines, because that tells us specifically, okay, we are in this time.
Yeah.
Yeah. But we'll do, you know, we'll do another one on that.
We're going to start chipping away at these little different things. Like, you know, what's the, you know, what is the apostasy, and where is that found in scripture, or and what does that look like? You know, start walking into the restrainer, you know, and people, and there's so much confusion about that. And we want to post some things that we've been hearing, and we believe it to be and open up the scriptures about that. So definitely a resource would be Robert Mowery.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Definitely go. We have him on our YouTube at the bottom. You can go to his channel. He is, I mean, we've learned so much from him.
Yes. He's a great resource to dive into these things and understand and have scripture open up. So definitely. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All this stuff is just great things to just think about
and pray about. That's what we're doing. We're saying it's time to pray and fast. Yeah. It's time to, you know, put your big girl pants on, big boy pants on.
Yeah.
And, you know, go into the prayer closet, get on your knees, go before the Lord, and know that He loves you. Know that He actually wants to not just give you the information, but then walk you through this time in a deeper revelation of His love for you, of His love for your family, and for the bride. And then He's coming back really soon.
Well, not only that, He wants us to walk in the power.
We're going to do
exploits. I mean, this is the best time for us.
It's supposed to be.
The best of times or the worst of times, depending on what side you're on.
Yeah.
All right. Well, that's a wrap on this episode of Let's Go There with Annalie and Annie. We hope it's brought you some good insight on the mark of the beast and encourages you to look into the scriptures for yourself.
Yeah.
Share this podcast on Instagram, TikTok, Spotify with your friends and family so they can get up to speed on where we are right now.
Days and the times. Yes. Know them. Yeah.
See you next week on another episode of Let's Go There with Annalie and Annie.